Now, we are officially starting our series with the halfback position in Road to Glory of College Football 25, man. And it's that time we go ahead and take a look at this elusive back. And the reason we chose this is because of the abilities that we get, such as takeoff, sidestep, shifty, and of course that 360. But don't sleep though, that quickness rating being able to get all the way maxed out along with elusiveness, we're gonna be sliding out here with absolute ease. And then we take a look at the fit, man, we kept it super simple. And of course it's that time we go ahead and equip our mental abilities. We went with the natural because we don't want any weather messing with us when it comes to getting on that field. We're starting off at 79 overall. You see him at 6'2", 215, that man run him. It's that time to make our commitment. Now, the first team we really wanted to take a look at was the University of Miami with Cam Ward, Xavier Restrepo, but they were loaded in the backfield and really didn't have space for me. Then I wanted to take a look at my top 12, and honestly, I didn't like any of the fits outside of Nebraska, which I didn't think that was going to be the best option. So we decided to look at the Syracuse Orange with Kyle McCord at quarterback, and they have a sleeper defense. They're building up there in New York. So it's that time we go ahead and go up to the Orange and see what we can do. And hey, you see we're still sitting at 79 overall, no coaches boost, but the ratings are looking good, especially starting off with 92 speed in this thing. So now you officially see what team we're on with the Syracuse Orange, man. And look, we got a nice schedule ahead of us, and what we're going to try to cover in this video is we're going to go down the first 5 to 6 games. So hopefully by the end of this one, we can actually have a decent look at what we can finish the season with Ohio, Georgia Tech, Stanford, FCS East, and UNLV. So just so everybody is aware, we are going to be playing on Heisman 5-minute quarters just so we can get through more of the season in a lot of these videos. But with the first game of the season, you see we got Ohio, and they're a solid 73 overall, so it shouldn't be too much to worry about out here. And hey, we're sitting pretty with that 82. Hey, let's see if we can handle business. And look, we're officially taking the field for our first time in this season, man. And look, you see we got a nice 3-0 lead. We got some zone fake jet though. Make sure I follow my blockers here. And oh my, I did not expect that one bit. And this is something a lot of people have talked about, is that if you're playing running back, they're gonna line you up at wide receiver out here. Let's see though. Look, just a simple corner route and nothing going for me. And they really got me out here as the fourth wide receiver versus having out like a freshman or something like that. That's crazy. Let's see though. Hey, look, I was underneath though, and four kind of scooting. Now we're finally in the third quarter, and we can probably get a little bit of love here. Let's see though. Going to the inside here. Hey, making that safety miss though. Hey, the final minute left, he needs to go ahead and give this to me. We got a 9-3 lead right now. Nothing too crazy. That safety's rolled down just a bit, and I got not a lick of blocking there. And crazy enough, they're bringing me out for victory formation out here. Hey, I'll take it. Long as we get the dub in our first game, I'm happy about it. And if we take a look at the player stats right now, look, our rushing attack is not that great. 18 attempts, 78 yards, and myself, 3 attempts and 3 yards. I gotta clean that up quickly. Now, officially going into this next week, we have 6 skill points, so we're gonna go ahead and add this to elusiveness. That way we can get as high as of that as possible, getting us to 93 agility, 90 change of direction, and eventually we'll be able to add shifty to our arsenal. And it looks like I'm getting my first touches out here with 1:30 left in the first, and you see they got a little run play for us. Motion with the tight end, and I'm gonna find a little space up here, and I should have just kept running to the outside. Looks like he's bringing me back in too, which is good. Got me dragging across the field quite a bit here. Let's see if it works. Got a little time. We gonna go ahead and possession catch that though, putting us in 3rd and 3. Me coming in to help earlier, getting those big gains, actually got us 7 on the board, which is nice to see, but Georgia Tech matched it. See if we can work on this corner route. Got guys underneath coming available. Big first down for the Orange. And I'm actually staying in on consecutive plays, which is the first time we've seen that this season. Got a little all go right now. He got me in the middle if he wanted. I'm going to go ahead and catch that. And I try to secure it and keep running. And the good thing about it is that he's sticking with me right now. 45 seconds remaining. The outside release here, man, is banging back to the inside too. Now we've officially hit overtime and it's 17-17 right now. And unfortunately, I didn't get to play ever since that last possession where we actually scored and got 14. So it's that time we get up the field here. Banging it back to the inside, they're running the same plays out here. Now Georgia Tech has made this game a do or die situation for us. 32-24 right now, 3rd and 10. I mean, such desperation moments, right? Let's see though. Let's see, catching it. And oh my, I was literally right in that window to do something. And it looks like we possibly gotten a penalty on that last play, which isn't a good look. 4th and 7 though. Can we get out here? And that's the game. I tried to bang it to the outside. I didn't think he was going to sink back in cover two like that. And Georgia Tech got the victory off my errant throw. And at the end of that game, Kyle McCord didn't play bad. 14 completions, 60%, 2 TDs out here. And we go to the rushing side of things. Hey, look, I had 1 carry for 13 yards. But our starter, he ended up hitting over the century mark. So that's not bad at all. And so far this season, we're sitting at 1-1. And we have a huge ACC matchup coming up against the Stanford Cardinals. And they are 82 overall team. So we're pretty neck and neck. We got to see if we can handle business, though. Another at home game at that too. But with 3 minutes left in the first, we finally got our first opportunity in this game versus the Stanford Cardinals. You see it, just a simple inside zone though. They're putting me one-on-one with the guy in the middle and I'm making something out of nothing. And we're all the way in the fourth quarter down by 4 points. And you see, this is what we're working with. A 3rd and 7 situation, they're making us work for it. And I don't know who he's throwing that to. And he absolutely throws a mean pick. I don't know if that was intended for me or for somebody else, but he didn't waste no time. And with the 17-6 deficit, it looks like we're going to potentially drop this game. I'm not going to lie to you, especially with what's going on out here. Tried to catch it and keep running though. 1st and 10. Can we go hurry up a little bit here? Got me in this slot receiver position. I'm not necessarily a fan. I'm not going to lie to you. We're going to come back on that. And it only got 3 yards. So it looks like coach is really hammering it home that he wants me on the field in some capacity, but it may be a little too late for that. And that's a mean pick he threw to the other side, man. I'm coming in trying to dive and get a tackle, but hey, we're dropping this one, absolutely. And our third game on the year going to 1-2. Stanford 17-6 over us, and this is painful. Coach isn't giving us a chance to shine out here on the field whatsoever, but Elik Iomanner, 2 catches, 27 yards, 1 TD, doing what he gotta do. Now, because we've had such a negative season, I'm hoping that I actually get a few more carries in this FCS East game. We got a decent front right now. Let's see though. Hey, look, I'm over here reaching for that first down line and coach is immediately taking me out. Good thing is we got 7 on the board, and the blessing with this is that we can change the play. We're gonna go ahead and call on our own number right now with some 94 will. Got me. Little lane there. We're juking, and that's a 1st down. I didn't think I was going to be seeing one of these plays this soon in our career, though. We got a halfback screen on this. Getting it out to me. Making the first man miss. Punishing them just a little bit. Big 7 yards out here. And against FCS East, we came away with a 20-3 victory. We contributed in the ways I felt like we needed to, running the ball, catching our first screen, and of course our starting running back, he's putting up numbers, so it's not like he's a slouch out here. I may have made the wrong decision coming to this school. And now we finally have our first game on the road in Vegas versus UNLV Running Rebels, and they're an 80 overall team, so we should hopefully get a decent lead on these guys, and hopefully we get a few more reps in this one. And with 3:30 in this game, man, we're finally in the money zone and having an opportunity to score here. Let's see if we can actually make something shake here. I'm letting my blockers get there though. And look, you see how patient I was with the rock. We get a nice 10-0 lead right now, 4:12 left. And hey, Kyle McCord has set it up to where I have no linebackers in the box. I'm following 74 the whole way, and we only get back to 3rd and 10. And with the more reps I get, you're gonna notice how patient of a runner I am. But that's how you bust those long ones. Pause. But here, 1:38 left. Let's see if we can get out here. And hey, that man is scooting. And it's our first 6 to be a part of with the Syracuse Orange out here. You feel me? Look, we tried to make our route quick and tight. A little screen action for him gave him just enough space. Deep into the fourth quarter with a 19-10 game. They got a little halfback slam right now. And look, hey, that defensive lineman got off that block so quick, we didn't stand a chance. And you know what? We did just enough in our first road test to come away with a 19-10 victory over the UNLV Running Rebels, man. And I ain't mad at it one bit. Of course, our running back, once again, he's putting up amazing numbers. And that's not a good look for me because it's giving them no reason to give me more playing time, to be fair. And the good thing about this game, we're going into a hostile environment. You see the toughness rank that we got going against. Number 24 in the country, 1st and 10, though. Got me out here, and I'm scooting to the outside a little bit. That corner was way out there. 2nd and 1, though. And look, the unfortunate part is there have been multiple opportunities that I've had a chance to come in at random times, and then it'll hit like the 2-minute warning or something like that. But hey, he's throwing a mean pick across the middle, and it's been not a good look this season for this man, Kyle McCord, when it comes to those quick passes. Now we're officially down big in this one, but you see I got a simple vertical route, 3rd and 14. They put me in situations that are not healthy, but hey, we're going to possession catch that just before the safety takes our head off. And now it looks like they're bringing me back in the fourth quarter. This may be time though, you know. We're pretty much already giving them the game. Let's see if we can make something shake here. And I'm not making anything move on that. We got a terrific 4th and 17 situation. This isn't good whatsoever. So we're going to probably turn this into some type of Texas route. And what a pass. This man made a way. And look, this game is possible right now, to be fair. We can actually make something shake. Let's see though. Does he flip the play? Not one bit. We're getting out of bounds, getting 3 yards. And we actually ended up getting into overtime, which is the crazy part, 17-17. This game did not look this way early on, but we got a stretch play and the backside is not letting us live one bit. We still somehow found a way to score, which is good. Now I got deep verticals down the field. You see how long I got to streak this. He got me in the middle, and I don't have the hands to bring that in. I'm letting my team down yet again. And somehow, some way, our kicker decided to become clutch, knock that thing down, and we got that 3-point victory over the NC State Wolfpack. And our running back has gotten player of the game the last 4 games. Yeah, I think it's time that we go ahead and hit that portal because our freshman year has not been what I thought it would have been. Now we finally hit a midpoint in the season where we can check up on our overall, and we have 6 skill points throughout those last few games. We're going to go ahead and add this to elusiveness, which is going to get us up to 99 agility, 91 change of direction, 95 juke move. So the next time we get a few more skill points, we should be able to go ahead and improve shifty and sidestepping. It's not looking like I got that 93 change of direction. Let's go ahead and check that real quick. So I actually have to max out elusiveness before I even have a chance to upgrade shifty at all. But since we've been losing games, coach has now put us up for a position battle with the number one running back, and he has been having a tremendous season. So look, this is going to be interesting. And after winning 2 of the 3 drills, we ended up getting the halfback 1 position. So this week is going to look way different for us. And to have this game on rivalry week is crazy. They're an 82 overall team with a solid offense. So look, we got to really be on our P's and Q's out here. Let's see if we can make sure we get this dub. Now we're officially taking the field for the first time as a starter. The main thing is, can we actually make a different impact than the person before us? Big juke, and I see my offensive line getting a massive pancake. First play from scrimmage and we get a 1st and 10. That's beautiful to see. Little inside zone action. I'm following 74, bouncing to the outside here. And hey, we are marching right now. Now we got some halfback wham. Once again, trying to be patient as possible. I know some of these D linemen are going to fight through though every time. And look, if we getting 8 yards a pop, I'm happy. 3:40 left and the stadium pulse is not on our side. This crowd is rocking. 73, he got a decent hole there. Just enough for me to get that. First pass play from scrimmage. Now we got a chance to block here. Trying to make sure I'm in the middle there. And hey, he got enough time. And with this man running, we're going to be officially a running team. You know what I mean? And A, fighting forward 3 yard gain, not bad. We got some dagger action too. Hopefully we can actually make something shake. Got a little check and release here. He's throwing a very, very suspect pass there, man. That's crazy. I mean, that safety didn't have to work hard for it at all. He was literally in the back pedal, T-stepped it, and just came straight up the field. I think the good thing we can say is that we have, I think, 5 rushes and 35 yards. So we're actually being extremely positive when we do get the rock and we bouncing this out. Now, we only got 92 speed right now, but we're finding a way to get our first big run of our career with this man run him out here. They thought I wouldn't take it to the outside, but if we got lanes, we bouncing that bad boy. 39 yards on them. And the good thing is coach isn't immediately taking me out, and I got the hot symbol too. Little halfback draw. And that window was so tight, we didn't really have anything to do there. Now let's keep the positive progression though. I have a little bit of a choice route here. I'm probably just gonna continue on with the motion. He's throwing it quick right now. Now I got my first Texas route, 3rd and 9. I can't get too antsy though. I just gotta make sure I get out here. Beautiful. Can we make something shake here? A lot of space moving up the field. Let's see if we can go some inside zone split though. We got our guys having them on their heels. Can we march though? And I thought 50 was gonna push. That was probably our shortest run of the day. We don't need to continue that trend at all. Look at this, we're gonna bounce this out. You feel me? And look, there was nothing to the inside, but we made a way. Now coach is going with this Y corner play on a 3rd-and-3 situation. We really need to score here though. I ain't gonna lie to you. He had options. Can we get him in the end zone? And I tried to go push that man and we got 6. Look, Cal McCourt had nothing but time there. And you see me, I was ready for the tush push action. With 1:13 left, we ran this play quite a bit. I won't even lie to you. Let's go ahead and switch this to an inside zone. Look, the D-line is shifting just a bit. No worries though. And oh my, I did not think 4 was gonna have that type of speed. 2nd and 14, and we have a chance to do a halfback seam here. Rarely get an opportunity with these. And we're getting good, decent yardage there. A little double post. I got a check and release. Let's see what this safety is gonna commit to though. Okay. And nothing's happening to the outside and we're giving this rock away. A little Z spot here, 1st and 10. Got me on this swinging route. Let's see. And that's a risky curl, but hey, it worked out. The main thing we got to pay attention to with this halfback base is that I got to follow 74 through the hole. Go ahead and lead me. And look, the other guys weren't holding up their end. The good thing about this play is we're simply just blocking, which I'm not mad at one bit. 55 tried to come through and we did our job on that pro style status. A lot of quick game type plays here. See, he had me out here and I would have gotten a little bit more at that. And now we have some wide corner, just a quick curl though. Nothing crazy. I'm glad he didn't find me and homie is dropping the rock. 2nd and 10 situation, I got a check release. I don't necessarily have to run it. And beautiful, tight end. And he's grabbing that first down. For some reason, we're choosing not to run the ball quite a bit on this. So I got a choice route here. See? Oh my, he easily could have caught me. 2nd and 8, and we're finally going back to the ground. It's been a minute and I've been patient. See though? Man, if it wasn't for that linebacker seeing what I was seeing. And we're moving pretty well though. Bunch trail. A lot of trash in there though. Oh man, Kyle McCourt getting hunted back there. Hopefully we can grab 3 in this though. So right now we got 12 rushes, 85 yards. We're pretty much on pace to do the same thing that the starter was doing. Nothing crazy though. He had me on this Texas route and he just wasn't patient enough. Maybe a little smash return. And we definitely need to space it out just a bit more. I ain't gonna lie to you. Got me? Can we slide? 1st down. Now we have a little bit more space than we had before. We can probably run this. Let's see if our guys can get off. Yes, indeed. We're making something shake and grabbing the 1st down and I'm fumbling the rock. I'm hoping I was down on that, but that's tough. Look, once you get contact, sometimes you can't even control what your player is doing. I was just in an animation and I was trying to go down. So now we check the replay. I got through, had a decent run there. And maybe I think that was down by contact. So the unfortunate part about that whole circumstance is that I did fumble the ball. And that's crazy to know that I did. But he's going to the out route. 1:25 left. We got quite a bit of time here. Got a little halfback screen. He won't throw it. I got to give these boys some time to get these blocks though. And hey, first and 10. The main thing I have to do is stay patient. I can't get too eager to hit the hole and get out of there. But 43 is not waiting. Now we got some all goals. We're probably not winning this game. Just to say that. Let me get to the outside here. I'm going to just run out of bounds. We got a third and 2. And the unfortunate part, we dropped to our rival. 21-13. Not a good look. And hey, it is what it is. I did fumble the rock, so I'm probably going to lose my spot. But, you know, we got a few more years to possibly run it back with these boys. But as far as my first game as a starter, Kyle McCord had a really efficient game, 80% completion percentage. And on the rushing side of things, I had 14 carries, 93 yards. Yo, I did my thing outside of that fumble. We just gotta tighten up there. So now we're at a point in the season that I feel like we can take a look at the big picture overall of our season. And we won against Ohio. Georgia Tech, we took a loss. Stanford didn't go so well. Then we went on a 3-game winning streak and lost against our rival. So now we have a slate of another 5 games ahead of us. And then we're going to finish this first season in the next video. So if you like this style, seeing more of the season overall, let me know in the comment section. Your boy Till would truly appreciate it. And also we hit 84 overall with this man run. I'm out here closing in on that change of direction, getting above 93, which is what I'm looking for to get that shifty trait. But outside of that, if you enjoyed this style of video, make sure to let me know in the comment section, like the video and turn on those notifications, because hey, we'll have more styles like this. That way we can get through more of the season and you can see more games overall. But outside of that, I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.